Dear students, welcome back to my channel and thank you very much for your wonderful responses on the previous video on organic chemistry. And I am honoring most of your requests in this video. And in this video, I am discussing questions on chemical equilibrium. And here, I am telling you the shortcut methods and also easier way to solve the problems on effect on equilibrium and also the equilibrium constant Kp and Kc. Enjoy the video and let me know your feedback. Thank you. Dear students, let us see the solutions for the questions that have been asked in the examination, right? Now here, the question is given. The question is, the equilibrium constant Kp for I2 plus H2 is giving us the 2HI at 800 Kelvin is 50. Then what is the equilibrium constant for 2HI getting converted to I2 and H2? At the same temperature. So in the first case, I2 combining with H2 to give 2HI, whereas in the second equation, it is 2HI is getting converted to I2 and H2. For first equation, equilibrium constant is given, whereas for the second, we have to find out. So conventional method is equilibrium constant K is equal to molar concentrations of products to that of reactants, molar concentrations of the reactants. So by that method, we can solve it. So it takes quite a bit of time. So instead of that, let us deduce the formula which can be used as a shortcut formula. So the formula has been derived by taking the conventional equation. So for the reaction, A plus B getting converted to C plus D, let the equilibrium constant be equal to K1. Then equilibrium constant K1 is equal to molar concentrations of products, that is molar concentrations of C and D, to that of reactants, that is molar concentrations of A and B. Now I will reverse this equation. That is, what I do is, when I reverse, C plus D is getting converted to A plus D. For this, let the equilibrium constant be equal to K2. So what I have done is just reversed it and then taken the equilibrium constant as K2. Now I want to find out the K2. K2 by conventional method, K2 is equal to molar concentrations of products. Products is here A and B, that is molar concentrations of products to that of reactant, that is C and D here. This expression K2 is equal to molar concentrations of A and B to that of C plus C and D can be written as 1 upon molar concentrations of C and D to molar concentrations of A and B. But we know that molar concentrations of C and D to that of A and B is equal to K1. So simplified here, when I simplify that, I will be getting 1 by K1. So K2 for this equation is equal to reciprocal of the equilibrium constant of this equation, right? So the expression is K2 is equal to 1 by K1. This is the simplest formula. If you know the equilibrium constant for the first equation, the on reversal, whatever the equation that we get for that, the equilibrium constant is equal to reciprocal of the first equilibrium constant of the first expression. So, first equation. Next, so the simplest formula is this. So, if A plus B get converted to C plus D is K1, then for C plus D to A and A plus B, the K2 is equal to 1 by K1. So, use this formula for this. Here, A plus B, A plus B is this, A and B giving rise to C and D. And here, C and D is getting converted to A plus B. So, same as this. So, apply that rule. So, when I apply, let me take that equilibrium constant, that Kp is equal to 50 for this reaction. I to give, combining with H2 to give 2HI. And then, on reversal, that is, if I reverse that, 2HI getting converted to I2 and H2. So, for this, K2, instead of K2, I call it as, this is K1, here K2 has been called as K dash P. For that, at the same temperature, that K dash P is equal to 1 upon Kp. So, Kp is known, substitute that 1 by Kp, Kp is 50, that is equal to 0.02. So, for this reaction, equilibrium constant is 0.02. So, this is the shortcut method. So, for the reaction, A plus B getting converted to C plus D is K1 as the equilibrium constant. For the reverse of that, equilibrium constant is equal to 1 upon K1. So, by this, you can solve the problem. Let us go to the next one. Dear students, let us see the next question and different question and different rule for the solution. The equilibrium constant Kp for I2 plus H2 giving rise to 2HI 800 at 800 Kelvin is 50. Then what is the equilibrium constant for 2I2 plus 2H2 giving rise to 4HI at the same temperature? Here what has been done is, equation, first equation, has been multiplied by 2R. It has been doubled here. So here the coefficient is 1, here it is 2. It has been doubled here. So for this, so since this has been doubled, will the equilibrium constant will also be doubled as 100? There is a 100 here. Let us see whether it is correct or not, right? So that has been deduced as rule number 2. So for that, let me take the equation f as being equal to c plus d. Let the equilibrium constant be equal to c1. Then k1 is equal to molar concentrations of products to that of reactants. So that is this. Now what I will do is similar to this. Here it has been doubled. Here I will generalize it. I will multiply this equation by n. This has been raised to n. So n number of a combines with n number of b, giving rise to n number of c and n moles of d. So then let the equilibrium constant be equal to k2, and this k2, equilibrium constant k2, is equal to molar products of molar concentrations of products. So that is molar concentration of c to the power n, n is the stoichiometric coefficient here, and similarly d to the power of n divided by a molar concentrations of a to the power n into b to the power of n. So this could be written as molar concentrations of c and d to that of a and b whole to the power n. So that is equal to this, right? But we know that molar concentrations of c and d to that of a and b is equal to k1. So simplify this, replace it by k1. So this is equal to k1 to the power n. So that means k2 is equal to k1 to the power n. So if equation 1 is multiplied by n number of times, then the equilibrium constant for the second equation, that is k2, is equal to k1 to the power n. N will be the coefficient to which the first equation has been multiplied, right? So here it has been multiplied by 2. The n here it is 2, right? So n is nothing but the coefficient, I1 is nothing but the number with which this equation, first equation, has been multiplied. So here n is equal to 2. So using that we can solve the problem. So this is the generalized formula. So just this is the shortcut formula. This you take this to solve this, right? So a plus b is nothing but i2 plus h2, and take that is equal to k, giving rise to 2hi, giving rise to that will have equilibrium constant 50, k1 is equal to 50. So k2 has to be determined. So for that, so this equation first one has been multiplied by n is nothing but 2 here, 2i2 plus 2h2 giving rise to 4hi. So here k2 is equal to k1 to the power n is equal to 2 here. So simplify that. So k2 is equal to k1 to the power of 2, k1 is equal to 50 here. So 50 to the power of 2, that is equal to 50 into 50, that is equal to 2500 or 2500. It is not 100, but it is 2500. This is the common mistake. If this is doubled, then the k will also be doubled. That is the common mistake what most of the students will commit. So we have to be very careful here, right? So shortcut method is k2 is equal to k1 to the power of n. So where n is nothing but the number with which the first equation has been multiplied, right? So that's it. Go to the next problem, the different problem and another different rule, right? Let us see that. Friends, let us see the question. For the following reactions, equilibrium constants are given. Give equation. What is that? Sulfur, which is in solid form, combining with oxygen, to that is in equilibrium with SO2 gas, and K1 for this is 10 raised to 52. Again, second equation, 2 sulfur in solid form, combining with 3O2, which is in equilibrium with 2SO3, and K2 for this is 10 raised to 129. So the equilibrium constant for the reaction, wherein 2SO2 getting combining with oxygen to give 2SO3, is how much, that has been asked. So here 2SO2 combines with O2 to give 2SO3. So this is what is required here. So for this we have to find out, mind you. So 2SO2 is in the reactant side. So this is the equilibrium that has been asked. So in the equation number 1 and 2, SO2 is not there on the reactant side, but it's on the product side. And here in the product side there is only one SO2, whereas here it is 2SO2. So that means this SO2 has to be reversed. Equation 1 has to be, rule number 1 to be followed. And then not only that has to be multiplied by 2. That means you have to raise to the power 2. So that means rule 2 is also been adopted here. And for this, what is the equilibrium constant need to be identified or determined. And this has appeared in JW 2019. Normally, JW examination questions will have more than one questions in it. So there are already 2 to 3 questions are there in it. Let us see that. So we need to apply rule 1 and also rule 2, and along with that we have to apply rule 3. What is that? Let us see that. So here let us consider A getting converted to B. A is in equilibrium with B. When A converted to B, let K1 be the equilibrium constant. Then in another next case, what happens? B is getting converted to C, and for that let the K2 be the equilibrium constant. Then for the reaction A getting converted to C, that means you add these two equations 1 and 2. When you add, BB get cancels with one another, then we will be getting A converted to C, and that is in equilibrium with one another. And for this, the new equilibrium constant K3 is equal to product of equilibrium constants of first and second equations, that is K1 and K2. So K3 is equal to K1 and K2 for the reaction A giving rise to B, and for which K1 is the equilibrium constant, and for the reaction B getting converted to C, and for to which K2 is the equilibrium constant. Then for the reaction A getting converted to C, the new equilibrium constant K3 is equal to K1 into K2. This is the rule of that has to be formed, shortcut formula that has to be utilized here. Look at this, it is just like this. A getting converted to B and B getting converted to C. In the last case, A getting converted to C. So then for this, A getting converted to C, then the equilibrium constant is equal to product of the equilibrium constants of this and this. So, but it is not direct, because it is SO2 is only one is there, and that has to be taken to the reactant side. So how to solve this? Let us go to that, right? So required equation is 2SO2 plus O2 in equilibrium with 2SO3. So this is to be required, right? So to get this, we need 2SO2. So for that, what I will do is, here only one SO2 is there, just first I will multiply this by 2. So I multiply the equation number 1 by 2 to get, so as to get 2SO2. To get 2SO2, multiply equation 1 by 2. When you multiply this by 2, that means it raised to power n. So n is equal to 2 here, so that means K1 will be raised to the power n. So then the new equilibrium constant Ka for that multiplied equation, Ka is equal to K1 to the power n is equal to 2 here. So Ka is this, that is 2s plus 2O2 in equilibrium with 2SO2, and for that Ka is equal to K1 to the power n is equal to 2 here, that's equal to K1. K1 is 10 raised to 52 and whole to the power 2, that's equal to 10 raised to 104. So this is the Ka. So what I have done, I multiplied this by 2. But where I want this 2SO2? I want it on the reactant side. So then what I will do, I reverse this equation. What is that? Equation number B. I reverse this equation so as to get SO2 on the reactant side. So as to get the SO2 on the reactant side, I will reverse this equation B. When you reverse that, then the equilibrium constant Ka will be 1 by Ka. The new equilibrium constant for this new equation, that is reversed equation, is Kb, that is equal to 1 by Ka. So when you reverse, 2SO2 giving rise to 2S plus O2, and for that new Kb, new value, new equilibrium constant Kb is equal to 1 by the previous equilibrium constant, that is Ka. So when you do that, this is the simplified form, that is on substitution 1 over 10 raised to 104. Now I got 2SO2 on the reactant side, and required number is there. Now apply the next rule, that is rule number 3. What is that? A getting converted to B and then B getting converted to C, then what will be the for A to C? So for that, so I have this expression SO2 in the expression here in the C. So this equation number C, multiply this equation C with what is that? SO3 is there in the K2. So multiply C with the equation number 2 so as to get the equation number 3, that is to get the K3. So to get K3, I will multiply equation number C, that is this equation, with K2, this is this one. So when you do that, I will be getting 2SO2 plus O2 giving rise to 2SO3, and for that K3 is equal to, that is equal to, so equation for C, equilibrium constant is equal to Kb multiplied by, for K2 it is 10 raised to 129. Kb is equal to 1 over Ka, 1 over Ka is 1 over 10 raised to 104, into K2 is 10 raised to 129. So on multiplication and simplification, we get this as 10 raised to 25. K3 is equal to 10 raised to 25. So this is what the answer is. So here what we have done, we applied rule 1, rule 2, rule 3. What is the first thing which we have done? We have multiplied the equation by 2, right? So what we have done is multiplied the equation by n is equal to 2. So that means K get to the power n. So that equilibrium gets to the power n. then what we have done, we reversed it, and reverse half of the equation means, so k2 is the new equilibrium constant, that becomes 1 over k1, k1 is the previous the equation's equilibrium constant. So that we have done. Then the rule 3 is, if A getting converted to B and B to C, then A to C will be the equation. So to get the A to C, you have to multiply the equilibrium constants of both the previous equations. So multiply all the equilibrium constants, you have to get the answer. So this is how we will arrive at the answer. So this is the answer for the question which has appeared in JEE 2019. So all these three rules are extensively used in solving the problems. Okay, let us see the next problem. Dear students, let us see the questions that has appeared in the previous examinations, and these questions are on the rules that we have discussed so far. Consider the following gaseous equilibria with equilibrium constants k1 and k2 respectively. SO2 plus half O2 giving rise to SO3, for this equilibrium constant is k1. Then 2SO3 getting converted to SO2 and O2, and for this equilibrium constant is k2. The equilibrium constants are related as the k1, k2, how they are related has to be identified. And that has been given here, you have to identify which one is the correct one. So for that, find out the difference between first equation and second equation. In the first equation, SO2, O2 converted to SO3, they are in equilibrium. So SO3 is there in the product side. In the second equation, it is there in the reactant side. So that means the SO3 got reversed in the second case. So accordingly, equilibrium value will also get with altered. So first thing is SO3 get reversed. Then in the second equation, it is not only SO3 getting reversed, it is also getting doubled. So first is reversal and then getting double. So that is what we have to do. So clue is given, on the basis of it, find out the answer for it. Next, let us take the next question. For the reaction N2 plus O2 giving rise to NO, the equilibrium constant is K1. The equilibrium constant K2 for the reaction 2NO plus O2 giving rise to 2NO2. Then what is the K for the reaction NO2 getting converted to N2 and O2? So this is the required. For this, you have to find out the K, right? Equilibrium constant need to be determined. This NO2 is there in the second equation. This is obtained from 2NO and O. But 2NO itself is obtained from the first equation. That means N plus O2 giving rise to 2NO. So this is like this. A is getting converted to B. Then B is getting converted to C. C is what we want. So that means you have to add A first equation and second equation to get the C. C is NO2. So add first equation and with the second equation, that means first equation K will get multiplied with the second equation, and then we get NO2. And after getting that NO2, this NO2 is in the product side, but we want it in the reactant side. So reverse it. So first add and then reverse. After reversing, the number here it is 2, whereas here it is half of this 2. So here the power get reduced to half, right? Half of this one, first previous one. So first add these two, then reverse and then reduce the power. So this is what you have to do. Clue is given, and accordingly find out the value for the K in the final equation, right? What is that? You have to determine. Clues are there, determine that. Next, the equilibrium constant N2 plus O2 gave rise to 2NO. For this, K is the equilibrium constant. Then half of N2 plus half O2 giving rise to 2NO, NO. So for this, what will be the equilibrium constant? So you need to find out. So here this equation getting off. So find out the N value from here to here. So and accordingly, so K2 becomes K to the power of N, right? So N is the coefficient which is present here. So that's what. So find out the value by applying the rule. So that's about the questions which has appeared in the previous examination. Let us go to the next one. Now let us see the next equation. Question, in which of the following equilibria Kp is not equal to Kc? So we know to know how the Kp and Kc are related. 2NO gas in equilibrium with 2 N2 plus O2, carbon solid plus O2 giving us 2CO, 2HI in equilibrium with S2 and I2, both all are gas, NO2 plus SO2 both are gas with NO and SO3. So for this, we need to know the relationship between Kp and Kc, right? And for that, let us consider the equation N number of A combines with NB to give N moles of C and N moles of B. And for this equilibrium constant Kc, right, K is equal to molar concentrations of products to that of reactant, that is already known to us, right? Okay, and then concentrations of A to the power of n means that is molar concentrations of A at the equilibrium. So molar concentration is number of moles of the react that particular material divided by the volume, that gives the molar concentration of the material. Molar concentration at equilibrium is equal to number of moles of that material at equilibrium divided by the volume, that gives the molar concentrations. Okay, and then let us see if it is a gaseous reaction, right? Let at equilibrium then the equilibrium constant for this equation is V Kp, and that Kp is equal to partial pressure molar concentrations of partial pressures of the products to that of the partial pressures of the reactant. So that is Pc is the partial pressure of the material C, and Pd is the partial pressure of the material D raised to the power n, that is the stoichiometric coefficient in the equation, and Pi is the partial pressure of A at equilibrium, and that raised to the power n, that is the stoichiometric coefficient. Similarly, Pb. Now, will this Kp be is related to Kc? Let us see that if you apply the Pb is equal to nRT, right, and then the assume it as an idealistic condition, then we can relate Kp with respect to Kc, and for that we should know what the Pi is. As I told you, this is a partial pressure of the material A at equilibrium, that is equal to know this mole fractions of the A, that is the material A, into total pressure of the system. So if you know the mole fractions of the material at equilibrium and multiply it by the total pressure of the system, then we can find out the partial pressure of that particular A, and similarly all materials could be known. So by using the Pv is equal to nRT and assuming it as idealistic conditions, then we can deduce Kp is equal to Kc. When you do that, we come to know that Kp is equal to Kc into RT to the power of delta n. R is gas constant, T is the temperature at Kelvin scale, and R will be normally, since the concentration is expressed in terms of mole per liter, volume is in liter, R will be is 0.082 is the value whenever they are using this, and also the pressure will be expressed in terms of atmosphere, right? So here delta n is equal to Np minus nR. N is number of gaseous product, Npp for product, R for reactant in the series. Delta n is equal to Np minus nR. P comes first in the alphabetical series than R. So Np minus nR, number of gaseous products minus number of gaseous reactants will give delta n. So if you know this, you can tell, if you know the delta n value, you can relate Kp with respect to Kc. So Kp is equal to Kc into RT to the power of delta n. T is the temperature. At constant temperature, normally the reactions will be carried out. R is a gas constant, so temperature is constant, R is gas constant. Let us know, by knowing this expression, Kp is equal to Kc into RT to the power of delta n, this is the formula, using that we can find out. So first let us take that. What is it? So apply this rule 4 to this equation. So that is Kp is equal to Kc into RT to the power of delta n, right? So delta n is already, I told you that. So for the equation 1, so Np, number of gaseous product is 1 plus 1, 2, and reactant is also 2, 2 minus 2, that is equal to 0. Kp is equal to Kc into RT to the power of 0, anything to the power of 0 is equal to 1. So that means Kp is equal to Kc. So first equation, it is both Kp and Kc are same, right? So this is appeared in 2019. Next, come to the next equation number B. B is Np, number of gaseous products, this is a gas, 2, Np is equal to 2, a number of gaseous reactants, only one solid should not be taken, solid and liquids should not be taken. So solutions is different, it is a solid, so solid should not be taken, the concentration of solid is taken as 1, so that should not be considered. So number of gaseous reactant is 1, so Nr is equal to 1, 2 minus 1 is equal to 1, so Kp is equal to Kc into RT to the power of 1. So here Kp is not equal to Kc. So Kc is different from this. Kp is not equal to Kc in the equation B. Let us verify with the C and the D also. C, number of gaseous products are 2, 1 plus 1, both are gas, 2. A reactant is also 2, 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. So here Kp is equal to Kc here. Here also Kp is equal to Kc. So that's clear. Now in this last equation, again number of gaseous products, both are gas, 1 plus 1, 2, Np is 1, Np is 2, sorry, and here Nr, here also gas, this also gas, that's also equal to 2, 2 minus 2 is equal to 0, here also Kp is equal to Kc. So only this case in the B equation B, Kp is not equal to Kc. This question has been asked many times. This type of questions has been asked many a times in the examination, both in KCET, NEET, as well as in JEE. Right? This is from JEE. Now let us go to the next question. Next question. Now let us see the questions which has appeared in previous examinations. In which of the following, which one of the following equilibria Kp is not equal to Kc? So this is quite similar to the previous example. Kp is equal to Kc into Rt to the power of delta n. So Kp will be equal to Kc when Rt to the power of delta n, when delta n is equal to 0, Rt to the power of 0 is 1. So that is equal to Kp is equal to Kc. When delta n is not equal to 0, that is Np minus Nr, gaseous, number of gaseous products minus number of gaseous reactants. If that is not same, if gaseous products is not equal to gaseous reactant, then the Kp will not be equal to Kc. If they are same, then Kp will be equal to Kc. So what is that you have to find out here is number of gaseous products and gaseous reactants. So by knowing that delta n, you can tell whether it is same or different, whether Kp and Kc are equal to one another or not, that can be told by knowing delta n. Now let us go to the next equation for the reaction. SO2 plus half O2 converted to SO3, Kp is equal to Kc into Rt to the power of delta n. Delta n is shown as x here, where the symbols have usual meaning. Then the value of x is, what is the value of x? You have to identify it with the same, applying the same formula, you can find out delta n. Delta n is x here. Then for the gaseous reaction, 2B is converted to A, equilibrium constant Kp is dash to Kc. Is it greater than Kc or less than Kc? So again by delta n, you can tell from the mathematical expressions that you are going to get, whether you can, from that you can tell whether Kp is greater than Kc or less than Kc, that you can tell that. So next, a tenfold increase in pressure on the reaction, that is N2 plus 3H2 giving rise to 2NH3 at equilibrium, results in dash in Kp. Will it be increase in Kp or decrease in Kp or no change in the Kp, that you have to tell. So here, just verify here, what is that we are doing? We are increasing the pressure. Now let us see the equilibrium. In the equilibrium, there are 4 moles of reactants, 1 mole of nitrogen and 4 moles of hydrogen. That means 4 number is getting converted to 2 number. When the number of gases reduces, that means that here, what is happening here? In the equilibrium, number forward reaction is number get reduced, reverse reaction is number get increased. So if you increase the pressure, according to Li-Shetlyov's principle, equilibrium will decrease the pressure. Decrease in pressure takes place in the forward reactions. So more and more forward reaction takes place. Since they are in equilibrium with one another, so rate of forward reaction will be compensated by the rate of reverse reaction, that is backward reactions. So in an at an equilibrium, rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reactions. That means ratios of forward reaction to that of reverse reaction, that is backward reaction, remains the same. So that means the equilibrium constant will remain same. So will there be any change in Kp? No change in Kp, that's it. So that's what it is. So there will not be any change in the Kp value. Next, for a given reversible reaction at a fixed temperature, that's at constant temperature, equilibrium constant Kp and Kc are related to what? That you know already given there in the, at the top. So that's it. Now let us take the next question appeared in JEE 2019. The value of Kp by Kc for the following reactions at 300 Kelvin R respectively, right? That has been given, right? Value for these equations have been given. For that, Rt is equal to 24.62 dm cube atmosphere mole inverse, right? So you have to find out which one is correct among this set of four answers, right? So I will tell you the simplest way. It is by law of elimination. Which one is wrong? Eliminate the answers which is wrong. So first, let us try with first expression. So here, what is that you have to do is Kp by Kc is equal to Rt to the power of delta n. That is been derived from Kp is equal to Kc to the power of Kp is equal to Kc into Rt to the power of delta n. From this, we can derive this Kp by Kc is equal to Rt to the power of delta n, right? So here Rt is known. So first apply to this. So here in the equation 1, Np is gaseous product is 2, reactant is 1 plus 2, 2. The Np minus Nr is equal to 0, 2 minus 2, 0. So Rt to the power of 0 is, anything to the power of 0 is equal to 1, Kp by Kc is equal to 1. So Kp by Kc is equal to 1, equation A possible, B, answer B correct, C ruled out, it is not there, so C equation C you can eliminate it. So D is also there, one among A, B, D, right? Now let us take the next equation, second equation, equation 2. Gaseous products are 2, NP is 2, reactant is 1, 2 minus 1 is equal to RT to the power of 2 minus 1, that is equal to 1, RT is equal to 24.62. So second value should be 24.62 dm cube atmosphere mole inverse. It is there in the first equation, yes it is possible, and also not in second, that you can rule out. So C already ruled out, so B is also ruled out. So A and D, one among them will be correct. So here, so one among them. So next thing is, so what is that? First, second is known. Here 606 is there, here 1.65. It can be done in two means, right? So how? First take this equation. NP is 2, NR is equal to 3 plus 1. 4. So 2 minus 4 is equal to minus 2. Kp is equal to RT to the power of minus 2. RT to the power of minus 2. So that means minus 2 means RT is 24.62 into dm cube atmosphere mole inverse. So write the formula also for even units also to the power minus 2. It can be done in two ways. It can be done in two ways. Either you take this numerical or the units. Units are very easier. Dm cube minus 2 is dm to the power of minus 6. So in one A and D, find out which one has dm to the power minus 6. Here first dm to the power plus 6, here minus 6 is 1. Verify with the atmosphere minus 2, here atmosphere minus 2, here plus 2, that's also ruled out. Molecular minus 1 into minus 2 plus 2, here plus 2, here minus 2, so you can eliminate by that. So here by comparing this unit for that, so unit by comparing the unit you can find out that, so this is the correct and you can eliminate this. So this is one. Or else take this 24.62, that value Kp by K is equal to 24.62 to the power minus 2. So that is minus 2 means what? 1 over 24.62. This is 1 over 24.62 to the power 2, to the power 2, right? So now what you do? 1 over 24.62, this 24.6 can be approximately taken as, so taken as what? 1 over 25, you can take it as 25, right? So when you take it as 1 over 25, since it is 2, 1 over 25 into 1 over 25. 1 by 25 is equal to 0.04. This into 0.04. 4 into 4 is 16. This is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 3. It is here. It is not there. So by that also, we can eliminate. So there are two ways, either this or this. We can do that, right? So any one of will definitely work. So correct answer is D is the correct answer, right? So by comparing this, well, by the law of elimination, we can find out the correct answer. So answer is D. So this is how you can eliminate the incorrect answers in the question. Now go to the next one. Now let us see another question that has appeared, a tricky question that has appeared in ZEE 2019. So in the reaction N2 plus 3H2 gives us to 2NH3. The equilibrium constant of the above reaction is Kp. For this reaction it is Kp. If pure ammonia is left to dissociate, the partial pressure of ammonia at equilibrium is given by A, B, C, D. So these are all the values that are given for the partial pressure of ammonia. And at the same time, they have given that, assume that partial pressure of ammonia is very, very less when you compare with pressure, total pressure of the system at equilibrium. So at equilibrium, concentration of ammonia is very, very less. As you compare it with the total pressure of all the gases present at equilibrium. So here one thing which you have to know is, for this equation Kp is given, right? That is there. But what they are doing here is, we are starting with the pure ammonia. Normally when a system is in equilibrium, there will be some amount of reactants as well as the product. But what they have asked the partial pressure of the system, wherein which they are starting the reaction afresh. That means reversal of this. So there is no nitrogen and hydrogen in the beginning of the reaction. It is not this, it is a reversal of this. So that means you are starting with ammonia and made to dissociate. So from first equation to second equation, what you have done is the Kp got reversed. So Kp is equal to K dash P is equal to 1 over Kp. Now for this, in this system, that is when ammonia is getting dissociated to nitrogen and hydrogen, right? Then for that, what is the partial pressure of ammonia at equilibrium? So that means for that, find out the Kp expression. Kp expression is equal to partial pressures of products to that of product of the partial pressures of the reactants. That is P of N2 into partial pressure of hydrogen to the power 3 to that of ammonia to the power 2. So we have to find out the partial pressures of nitrogen, hydrogen, and we need to find out ammonia at equilibrium. So for that, what is the partial pressure formula? For partial pressure of nitrogen, that is equal to partial pressure of nitrogen at equilibrium is equal to mole fraction of nitrogen multiplied the total pressure of the system at equilibrium. Now for that, how to find out the total pressure? So from the total pressure of the equilibrium is equal to P, that is total pressure of the equilibrium P is equal to partial pressure of nitrogen plus partial pressure of hydrogen plus partial pressure of ammonia. So this gives the total pressure. But they have given that ammonia, that is the partial pressure of ammonia at equilibrium is very, very less. So that means to say that partial pressure of ammonia is almost zero, but it is not actually zero. So that means we can take this as a negligible as we compare to the total pressure. So that means we can neglect this PNH3 here. So if we do that, then the total pressure of the system is equal to pressure of nitrogen and pressure of hydrogen. So you know the partial pressure. Then we have to find out the mole fraction. How to find out mole fraction is equal to number of moles of that material, that is nitrogen, at equilibrium for the mole fraction of nitrogen, to the total number of moles of all gases present at the equilibrium. So that gives the mole fraction. Now by this, let us find out the partial pressure of nitrogen, hydrogen, and ammonia. So for that, first we have to know the total number of gases which are present at equilibrium. As is told, so what is that? Ammonia is getting dissociated to nitrogen and hydrogen, and almost all ammonia is gone. That means it will be completely converted to nitrogen and hydrogen. So that means at equilibrium, total number of gases are nitrogen and hydrogen. So there will be 1 mole of nitrogen and 3 moles of hydrogen which are present there. So total number of moles of the gases which are present there are 4 moles, because ammonia is negligible. So 4 moles of gases are present there. Then the partial pressure of nitrogen is equal to, right, mole fraction of nitrogen, that is total number of moles of nitrogen, that is equal to 1, divided by the total moles of the gases, that is equal to 4, multiply the total pressure P, that gives P by 4 is the partial pressure of nitrogen. Similarly, partial pressure of hydrogen is equal to number of moles of hydrogen present at equilibrium, that is equal to 3, divided by number of moles of total number of moles of all the gases, that is equal to 4, multiplied by the total pressure, that is P. So that means 3P by 4 is the partial pressure of hydrogen. So we don't know the partial pressure of ammonia, that is what we have to determine. So from this, let us find out the Kp value. So substitute this partial pressure in the equation 1. When you do that, so K dash P is equal to 1 by Kp, that is equal to P by 4, that is partial pressure of nitrogen, into partial pressure of hydrogen, that is 3P by 4 whole to the power of 3, divided by partial pressure of ammonia to the power 2. So we'll simplify that. What I will do is I will take NH3 to this and Kp, cross multiplication, what we get is partial pressure of ammonia to the power 2 is equal to P by 4 into 3P by 4 to the power 3 multiplied by Kp. So let me simplify this. I will take root on both sides. When you take root on both sides, partial pressure of ammonia to the power 2 by 2 is 1. So that's equal to, so here root of P to the power 4, that is equal to 1 by 2. And 3P by 4 to the power 3 by 1 by 2 is 3 by 2. And Kp to the power 1 by 2. So let us simplify this. When you simplify that, what is that? P part has been taken to one side. So that becomes P by 4 is equal to 4 by 2. 4 by 2 is nothing but square P by 4 to the power 2. So P square. So in the resulting equation, P square by 4 square is 16. Multiplied by 3 to the power of 3 by 2 into Kp to the power 1 by 2. That will be the partial pressure of ammonia. So here, what is that we have done is very simple. We have found out the partial pressure of nitrogen and hydrogen by the given data. But only thing that we have to find out here is, so is it is not the formation for which they have asked the partial pressure. It is for the dissociation of ammonia. It is for the dissociation of ammonia, means the reverse of that equation. So you have to read the question carefully so as to find the proper answer for the question, right? So unless until you read, it will be difficult to get the correct answer. So read the question carefully and then analyze what has been asked, and then assume or find out what are the assumptions that are given, and on the basis of that apply the common sense and find out the correct answer for the question. Next, Now let us see the questions that has appeared in the previous other examinations. The equilibrium constant for the reaction N2 plus O2 giving rise to 2 NO is 4 into 10 raised to minus 4 at 2000 Kelvin. In presence of a catalyst, the equilibrium constant is equilibrium is attained 10 times faster. When equilibrium it will attain 10 times faster in presence of a catalyst. Therefore, equilibrium constant in presence of catalyst 2000 Kelvin is how it is related. So here it's very simple. What the catalyst will do is to increase both forward and backward reaction rate. Forward and backward reaction will get altered and attains the equilibrium readily. So catalyst will help in attaining the equilibrium at a faster pace. That's it. So that means rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reactions. But the ratio remains the same. That means equilibrium constant remains same. There is no change in the value of the equilibrium constant. That's it. So find out the value here from the answers. Next question. The next question is, consider the following equilibrium in a closed container N2O4 converted to N2NO2. At a fixed temperature, the volume of the reaction container is halved. So, okay, the volume of the container has been reduced to half of the original volume. For this change, when you reduce that volume, so what happens there? Pressure increases. Which of the following statements hold true regarding the equilibrium constant and degree of dissociation? Please remember, at a given temperature, Kp is constant. There will not be any change in the value of Kp. But the variation in the pressure and volume will alter the degree of dissociation. Degree of dissociation will alter, but not Kp. So, a change in temperature may change Kp, but at a given temperature, so Kp remains same, but the variation in pressure and volume can vary the degree of dissociation. What will happen here is there is no change in the Kp, but degree of dissociation may alter, right? That's what it is, right? Now let us go to the next one. Now let us see the questions appeared in other examinations too. The question is, at constant temperature, the equilibrium constant for Kp for the decomposition reaction N2O4 giving rise to 2NO2 is expressed as Kp is equal to 4x square p upon 1 minus x square, where x is the degree of extent of dissociation, p is the pressure. Which one of the following statement is true? Already I have told, pressure and volume will alter the degree of dissociation, but Kp does not alter. So only pressure and volume can alter the degree of dissociation or extent of the rate dissociation. That's it. So answer already given. Now let us take the next question. For the reaction N2 plus 3H2 give this to 2NH3 at 500 Celsius degree Celsius, the value of Kp is 1.44 into 10 raised to minus 5. When partial pressure is measured in atmosphere, the corresponding value of Kc with concentration in mole per liter. So here pressure is in the atmosphere, concentration is mole per liter. So for this you have to find out Kp is what the relationship between Kp and Kc and find out the Kc value. Okay, Kp is given. Okay, this can be determined from the equation Kp is equal to Kc into Rt to the power of n. So Kc to be determined, Kp by Rt to the power of delta n. T is given, that is 500 converted to the degree Kelvin, and then R for the atmosphere pressure in atmosphere and concentration in mole per liter, R is equal to 0.082. Substitute, find out delta n and substitute in the expression, you will get the Kc expression in the form of mathematical value. Next question. For the reaction H2 combining with I2 giving rise to 2HI, the equilibrium constant Kp changes with what? Pressure and the volume does not change. Catalyst will also not change. Concentration will also doesn't change the equilibrium constant. Only thing which will alter is the temperature. At given temperature, equilibrium constant is constant. If you vary the temperature, equilibrium constant will vary. That's it. Now let us see the rules that are used to solve the problems. Rule number one, that is shortcut number one. If A is getting converted to B, that is A is in equilibrium with B, and for that equilibrium constant is K1, and for the reversal of that, B is getting converted to A, then the equilibrium constant, the new equilibrium constant K2 is equal to 1 upon K1. That is rule one. Rule two, for the reaction A is in equilibrium with B, that it is A converted to B, equilibrium constant is K1. Then if that is, if the first equation is multiplied by N, then the new equilibrium constant K2 is equal to K1 to the power N. So this K2 is expressed in terms of K1, and in the previous rule also K2 is expressed in terms of K1, right? So with the suitable modifications. These are the shortcut methods, the rules that are actually deduced from the normal chemical explanations. To the next rule, rule 3 is in A converted to B is the K1 is the equilibrium constant, in the B converted to C, K2 is the equilibrium constant. Then A to C, that is when you add A first equation and with the second equation, then the equilibrium constant K3, the new equilibrium constant K3 is equal to K1 multiplied by K2. This is the third rule, third shortcut rule that has been used to here to solve the problem. Next, in the conversion of NA combining with NB to give NC and ND, then the KP-KC relationship is equal to KP is equal to KC into RT to the power of delta N. Delta N is number of gaseous products minus number of gaseous reactants which are present at the equilibrium. So these are all the rules, four rules that are used in solving the problems. Okay. Dear students, please write your questions and your comments, and please like this video, share with your friends, and also subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much for your nice feedback, and please wait for the next video. In the next video, I will be discussing the effect of concentration and also the degree of dissociation and other concepts of equilibrium. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.